stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, who hear the angel voices, who was born. Oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night divine. Truly he taught to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we. Let all within us praise his holy.
You may be seated. Our first reading tonight is from Isaiah. It is chapter 52, verses 7 through 10. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices. Together they shout for joy, for in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth, shout together for joy, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has comforted his people, he has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God.
Perfect lamb, the sleep. sleeping child you're holding is the great I am. Mary, did you know?
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 Flesh keep silence.
Our second scripture reading is from Micah chapter 5. Verse 2 through 5a, the ruler from Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the end of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace.
Gently hold you, let my tender
This reading is taken from Isaiah 9, 2 through 7. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied exultation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult dividing plunder. And the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken on a day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in the blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom.
A reading from Titus chapter 3, verses 4 to 7. But when the goodness and loving kindness of God our Savior appeared, he saved us not because of any works of righteousness that we had done, but according to his mercy, through the water of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit. This Spirit he poured out on us richly through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that, having been justified by his grace, we might become heirs according to the hope of eternal life.
Arise, ye sleepers, awake from the night. The fifth reading, the birth of Jesus the Messiah. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be pregnant from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to divorce her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife.
Bow and he is in the manger now.
Christ is born today.
Christ is born today.
Christ is born today.
From the Gospel of John, first chapter, verses 1 through 5. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being? In him was life. The life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overtake it.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 through 20, the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among all people." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the word of the Lord. Friends, there are times in a worship setting when the word of the Lord stands on its own and no commentary is needed. This could well be one of those times. Luke's description of the birth of Jesus has been the defining mark of Christmas and Christmas Eve worship services throughout the ages, tonight being no exception. However, I am a preacher, so I find it hard to pass up an opportunity to preach, at least just a little bit. I promise you I'll keep my comments brief. In fact, I just want to share a story about a children's Christmas pageant held at a church. We've all been a part of those pageants, I'm sure, either as a participant, as a spectator, or for many of us, as both. Well, at this particular pageant, there were a large number of children participating, all dressed in their respective costumes. There were the sheep and the cattle, the camels, and a donkey. Mary was there in a blue mantle, and Joseph in a cotton beard. The wise men were there, more than three, to help make parts for all the children, and there were the shepherds. Of course, in the midst of it all, the baby Jesus was lying in a manger filled with straw. The story of Jesus' birth was read aloud, and carols were sung at the appropriate places. It all went like clockwork until it came time for the arrival of the angels of the heavenly host, as represented by the largest number of the church's children. They were all dressed in white, complete with their wings and shiny halos. At that one moment, all the angels were supposed to come forward from different places throughout the sanctuary, and with all the other characters, be gathered around the manger. This is just what they did, except there were so many children that there was a fair amount of crowding and jockeying for the closest position around the manger, everyone wanting to be by the baby, of course. This resulted in one little angel, smaller than the rest, ending up out on the far fringes of that crowd of characters, so far out that even by craning her neck and standing on her tiptoes, she could not see what was going on. The words of glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace among all people, rang out, and then everybody sang on cue. In the momentary pause that followed that singing, that one little angel, stuck way in the back of the crowded nativity scene, electrified the entire church by crying out in a voice shrill with irritation, but also anticipation, "Let Jesus be seen!" Friends, that's our call for this evening. Let Jesus be seen. Amen.
I'm so glad you're all here because you've just increased our choir size by about 5 times. This last medley of carols involves all of you. So watch the words on the screen and make a joyful noise unto the Lord. I tell my choir, you can sit down if you sit up. So let's really hear it, okay?
Thank you.
from Ephesians 5:8. For once you were darkness, but now in the Lord you are light. Live as children of light. I invite all who are able to rise, turn on your candles, and let us sing the last two verses of Silent Night. Thank you all for being here this evening, and now, blessed by the light of Christ, go forth into this holy night, and yes, let Jesus be seen. Go forth. Amen and amen. Go in peace.